Good afternoon. Welcome to World War Wednesday. It's the time of week that we really look forward to the most because
it's so fun.
We've got a whole bunch of conquering to do. We're going to be playing some more Hearts of Iron 4 for you with single player Japan by popular request, because it wasn't for certain that we were going to be doing this.
No. It was a lot of people just hoping some pinging Dan and Johan like I wanted. But you really said it, and we are going with it.
Yeah, we put the call out on the forums and everywhere. Do you want more Japan? And there was an overwhelming yes or
so
hi.
We're going with it.
Yeah. But first off, I want to pose a question to you that we got from the community, Daniel. And that is, who is Mr. Hitler's photographer here? Because he's looking a bit dark. And people have been bringing this up as we've streamed. So why is he in such poor lighting there?
This is the way we chose to censor the game for Germany, so we can apply it. Like, we took one very safe approach, and there are also some high-ranking officers that are in the same way. But everyone else, take it easy. You can still play with all the faces uncovered. So it's just for German people.
Yeah, so if you live outside of Germany, for example... Me, when I fly back to Scotland and I spend all my holiday playing Hearts of Iron 4, as I fully plan to do,
yeah,
I'll be able to see Mr. Hitler in proper lighting.
No, I don't really, like, at least I'm going to look at the front lines when I play the game, not stare at his face all the time.
I think we have different priorities for this game here.
Okay, but let's. And also, I was in chat right before the stream and saw that, sorry for slaughtering your nickname, but Quipshack, feel better. You said you were sick, so get well.
And we're going to give you the best get well message we can by slaughtering China.
Yeah.
All right, let's do this. So where were we? Where did we leave off before?
All right. I pressed in some in Japan. In China. So People's Republic of China, they joined the war. China has swallowed up all the minor nations to increase their forces. So all of those forces are probably like somewhere around in this area. So sooner or later, they will get to the front line. But if they just walk all the way, they will actually lose quite a bit of organization and won't be able to fight back right away. So hopefully, I can just gather up so I get one front again from the naval invasion I did last time here. And we're going to continue now. I just have some questions that I'm going through that people wanted more clarification. Then I'm going to play much more this session. As I have already talked away 5 minutes.
Yeah, we put a shout out on the forum. What do you want to see in the World War Wednesday? Because, I mean, we want to show this game to you. If there's something you want to see, just let us know. I've also got my eyes on the Twitch chat here. So just put at DDR Jake, and it'll highlight any questions you have. I'll pose them to Daniel whilst he's not busy crushing down on Chinese soil.
I always have it on pause this session.
Yeah, all right, let's do
but
it.
But I will have very, very slowly when I'm not.
No pausing, that's our goal then.
God damn it, Jake.
You said it.
Yeah, but I was going to maybe cheat a bit. People have been really calling for naval combat. I really want to show it up also, but I'm going to try push down this session here and just push away the Chinese Navy from the port so we can actually fight them, since my dear Japanese fleet is guarding all the exits for them, so they can't run away. If they get out, I will hopefully catch him. I'm actually just going to see. I have search and destroy on. No, I should have patrol on. So my fleet is much more spread out and can easily find their fleet without them escaping. Anyway, so let's continue with this battle. I'm pushing forward quite a bit on every front. Here, supplies looking kind of bad. I will actually remove these four troops. Yes, with strategic redeployment, so they move away very quickly, get out of the front, and leave all the supply for the troops that actually need it. Let's see. These are quite bad, actually. I'm looking at all the cavalry that I have right now.
You dare talk down the glorious Nippon army?
Parts of it.
There's room for improvement. That's how.
Since I attacked so very early, I still haven't reinforced all the infantry equipment.
And that's the thing, Daniel actually took the decision to plunge into China as quickly as he did through his focus tree. I mean, you could have taken various other paths on that. You could have chosen to do some innovations for your army ahead of time.
Look at this. Oof. I'm leaving this whole front just undefended. And yeah, of course, he's moving in to take it back, since I can't. I can't go and defend it. I really need to advance a bit more so I can actually get my supply. So supply is a very real problem in this game. And yeah, if they don't get food, if they don't get equipment, they won't fight. So I'm actually just figuring out, should I let them push back? Oh god, wrong map mode. Like, should I let them push back over here?
Well, are they going to stumble into attrition themselves? That might be handy.
And I will be in attrition's favorable territory. Since all the time that's gone now, I will just improve my infrastructure around here so I can move more troops in here. I want to gather up these soldiers, make one front, and get the naval bases here and supply. That would actually be quite good if I just try to force myself to the right side, yeah, where I've got better supply. Oh, right, we can also bring up now factories. People asking a lot
this
of questions
actually,
about factories.
Yeah, questions coming up all the time about factories and wars. So what do we have to say about that?
Yeah, we talked about it quite a lot, but let's just bring up it one more time. Factories in war. All states have certain amount of slots. You can see, like, I can see that this state that the People's Republic of China own have 4 slots. But since I don't own the territory, I don't know what. But there could be up to 4 possible buildings in here. And let's say 2 of them are civilian factories. I would get 2 of them. But still, depending on what kind of occupation law I have, I might not get all of it.
We saw this quite a bit in the multiplayer between Daniel and Johan, where different occupation policies were put in place. And pretty much once you were secure with your military police, you went on harshest. But that was unfortunate for the manpower, although you had plenty of laws to cover that.
Yes.
So, no pressure. It's just me and, oh jinx, thousands of people watching you play.
Oh god, oh god.
Actually, do I have a number on that?
Let's see.
Oh wow.
God. Bring your friends. We need to beat that Stellaris. We need to show that Hoi is the game.
There is actually a bit of inner competition here. It's like who gets the limelight when we're streaming this. So even though these are your auxiliary troops or your these weren't like full units, were they?
No, these are plain garrison divisions.
Yeah,
actually,
it's garrisons.
Quite bad equipment too. But as I see on their front, they have not the greatest organization or strength, as some people ask that also. What you can see here is, on the right side, fighting strength. It's like manpower, HP, and infantry equipment. On the right side, it's organization. So I can easily see they're not fully manned, so I can probably beat through that, since I even have air superiority here. But as you can see here, it would pop up if any of my airplanes had done damage or joined the battle. But since they haven't, I just have general air superiority of the area.
Okay, whilst you're pushing through, we have a question about, is it possible to change your country from fascist to democratic? And if so, how difficult is it?
I would say it's not super difficult, but if you don't start with, like, for me, to change democratic, it would take so long.
Yeah, the pie chart that he hovers over shows the politics inside the country, which is 100% in favor of fascism.
Yes.
So he would have to take a long and dangerous road towards democratic reformation, which would almost certainly result in civil war.
And it also says 0.10, but the more support you have of a certain party, the less that reformer will help. So when you're at 33%, I think it reduces by 60% or something, so you only get 0.04.
But you can also be influenced by other countries who decide to boost popularity for one faction inside your country.
Yes. Okay, let's continue now. As I saw, I finally linked this up, and I think it actually... No, it did not improve.
Why Studios is asking, why does Stellaris get a 2-hour stream and Hoi 4 only gets one? That's politics.
Actually, we added some new animations. As you can see, this unit is attacking, so therefore he runs at my unit, which is standing back. Like, my unit is attacking, switch it between some animations and running forward, just to easier see you, give you a glance about...
Yeah, this is a relatively recent addition, but it was just a case of, well, why not?
It has actually been in for a very long time, it was just never activated.
Yeah.
Like, even when they retreat, when they do a shameful retreat,
The Japanese forces never retreat.
And just look sad. Hopefully I can show it off somehow. Show it off.
Somebody's asking, what is the name of the fascist U.S.?
I think it's the Silver Legion of America.
Oh, wow. Some nations have really cool names for their ahistoric roots. I don't want to spoil most of them.
I can not see it.
But we do love our Thunder Dragon Empire around here.
Can I see it from here? Yeah, right. The Fascist Party, the Silver Legion of America.
I don't think we're going to be seeing that in our Japan single player.
No.
The Americans are very
They even
stalwart against political change.
Here, if you check here, ideology drift.
We had an agreement about pausing.
Oh.
I'm going to be hitting that space bar if he ever pauses.
It's just automatic in my mind, accidentally pausing it. Let's see. My supply situation seemed to have improved a little bit. No, they just pushed up. It was not better at all. Here, I really need to push in quite quickly now. Oh. Since if I don't push in quick enough, I don't get the state. See, I can hold over here and see that the control is currently China still, with 54% of the occupation.
Difference will be made if you end up with a majority of it?
I get supply from that state.
How about factories?
Factories, I gain control of them too.
Okay, so that answers the question here about... pardon me. The question about how the factories works with when you only partially control a province. So you have to control the majority of it.
Yes, so you can't just blitz or paratroop everywhere, take one province and like, I own everything. Mm-hmm. So you need actually the majority of everything. Oh god, these troops just horribly out of any organization at all.
There's a question asking if there's native support for Steam controllers. I don't even know where to begin with that one.
I don't know.
I think we'll throw that at Podcat.
Yeah.
And if there isn't, he'll be like, well, why not?
Yeah, I think he also will say exactly those words. Let's actually try to push ahead now. I just really need to force myself in here. Let's remove my support here and just add it. So I get more close air support. I will actually take this air wing. I will split it up so I actually have four of them. So some of the planes can engage in more battles at the same time. I'm actually thinking, yeah, I will split it up once more.
Indeed, like as our audio specialist would say, more is more, right?
More is more.
I mean, how could less be more? Makes no sense.
But, alright, we all really forgot. This build is so new, it's burning.
Yeah. There's still steam coming off of it. In fact, how recently was this one deployed?
Today.
Yeah, it's always worth noting that we play with live development versions here. They're not tarted up for your amusement here. We are working with, we're working with what we develop on. But that doesn't hold us back here, because we want to share the fun and the carnage with you.
Yeah, so what I'm doing now is just looking at the overall standard of a battle. I can even see it from here. How everyone that's engaged in a battle is doing, if he's defending, if he's attacking. Oh god, it doesn't look that well when I looked at losing. But I really try to keep a overview of everything.
I really liked a post we had on the forums where people tried to pick apart what each of the icons meant, and they did an incredibly good job.
Yeah.
I think the only one that they didn't get the little canister.
It means they're missing supply.
Mm-hmm. They are out of supply, and you don't want to be out of supply. I assure you that is one of the worst modifiers you can get for your troops, and you're out of supply.
It's super bad.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, you have the best weapons and tactics in the world, but your troops have no organization at all, so they can't do anything. Alright, now I'm going to continue. If you check my production, I have very few aircraft producing. But that's why I said I didn't want these all types of airplanes, and I haven't changed them because of it. They're going to get switched out as soon as possible, in 184 days.
Now, previously we had questions coming in about whether or not what happens to equipment for an annexed nation. And we've been saying that nothing happens to it, but hasn't that changed recently?
It has changed. You gain, I don't know actually the technical data behind it, but you get some of it.
Yeah. So I guess we can pull back all those times we said no, the nothing happens to the equipment. But yes, you do get a fair chunk of it.
Yes,
I noticed that because
it's quite awesome actually. I've actually built entire tank divisions by just borrowing their tanks when they surrendered.
We'll give it back eventually, I swear. Yes, when I was attempting Albania again.
Look, he's so sad. He was retreating.
Oh, I'm starting to feel sorry for these guys. Make it swift and painful for them.
Swift and painful? That's what merciful. Alright, I'm not beating through this. Like, all my attacks have just been beating back several times now, since the supply here is just... it's not even funny. I really need to reorganize this a bit. I can have two more soldiers there, so I'm gonna take these two. Send them packing this way. Just move them around.
There's some strategic redeployment there just to get them out of there.
Oh god, I now sent them on a real cruising. Like this. You can see by this icon that they actually are strategic redeployment now.
People are asking about the numbers that are showing up. You see for those battles you have like 29 in green, 74 in green. What does it mean?
It actually means it's going quite well. It's going a bit well. Not. This is like... I'm losing just by a very little tiny amount. I'm winning by a tiny amount. So even if you will actually lose the battle, you're winning. The battle. You're actually winning in that sense. Like, you're killing more troops, you're destroying more equipment. So
even if you lose a battle, if you do far more damage to the enemy, it's a strategic win for you.
Exactly.
Also, the arrow that's on it shows in which direction there is fighting going. Because you're either going to be fighting into somebody or having someone fighting into you. So the arrow will show you there. We're being asked, will there be cheats? Oh, heavens, yes. We're full of cheaters here. I wouldn't survive without my good old console.
It would be... console commands, basically giving you manpower, political power. Yeah, very basic actually. Not giving you equipment, but you could say, give me all the research.
Yeah, research all.
Yes.
It's not just because we're a bunch of massive cheaters around here. It's very helpful for debug.
That's what you're saying.
Yeah. Well, imagine if you had to test something and it's like, we need to find a situation where you have 2 million manpower as Albania. Go for it. And you're like, oh no, here we go again.
Here we can see a nice surrounding tactic. I'm just going to trap two of these divisions. Come on, get in there. My troops are moving so slowly because they don't have organization. You actually get a massive penalty of that. From that. I think my infantry is going to arrive there quicker than my cavalry.
People are asking how one division can win against four divisions. There was probably a battle going on where we had one defeating four of theirs.
They probably had no supply at all, so they're just getting pushed out.
There are a lot of factors that will come down to it. How is their organization? How is their supply?
Somehow. Like, if you can see, they have...
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Like, a quarter strength and half strength on this one and no organization. So I'm just continue pushing. Like, imagine Blitzkrieg. I just continue pushing, but the problem is then my supply will just completely die.
I mean, with supply like that, we're essentially fighting people who have gone full Russian, who have like 10 guns between them.
This is very interesting.
So what do we have here? The Anti-Comintern Pact.
So if anyone would get attacked by the communist menace, I will join them in that war if I joined the Comintern. And my opinion will also improve. Should I do it? Like,
are we going to post that to the chat then?
Yeah, let's actually.
Okay, we'll actually let you guys decide. So we have the Anti-Comintern Pact. So if we decide to join, we're going to join into wars involving communists.
It's if they attack.
Okay, so it's not if they are attacked.
It's a defensive pact.
Okay, defensive pact against the communists.
But
of course, how scared are we of the communists attacking?
It could be quite bad actually if they decide to.
It's actually really quite split down the middle here. Loads of people saying refuse, and also saying join. So I think we're gonna. Yeah, we gotta join it. Destroy the commies.
Hopefully I can. Yeah, here you can see actually the exact example. Since I have a bit more extra soldiers. I can rotate a bit, but there is dying. It's not possible. Oh, wait. Did I add? Oh. Never mind. As you can see, the AI is actually automatically using some strategic redeployment when they see, oh, I'm going to that part of the front, it's super far away. Let's use it, so I don't even have to press it for myself.
I notice you're hesitating at the river there, so just how bad is it to attack across a river?
Let's try out with someone that actually has supply. Here I pushed through. Like, this was one very important thing about my naval invasion here. I wanted to get past this river somehow. And it actually worked quite well. Let's see. That's why I'm not getting any supply at all. Let's upgrade the infrastructure here by highest priority.
For those that couldn't quite catch it, what was the choke point for your supplies?
Since I took this, since this is now connected to my main battlefront, my supply is all sent by from my capital through the ports over here. But the infrastructure over here is so bad.
Yeah. So not only was it not great to begin with, all this fighting has reduced it to rubble.
Improved the infrastructure.
Improved.
Making it to rubble. So I somehow need to really pull back most of my forces, but still not lose the war.
You don't want to. You don't want to lose your ground.
I'm actually going to zoom out a bit. Just so all types of units that are of the same type will just group up when I zoom out. So I will take the cavalry forces that you saw weren't that great actually, and just poof away. 10 divisions. Just send them far away. They can come back later when they have.
Yeah, I mean they have a fair amount of equipment, but yeah, they need to dust themselves off. Okay, we just got one of the stronger bonuses. That is an extra research slot. We're already up to 5, which is
so
quite a lot.
I don't know what to pick actually. I think anti-tank. Since if we're ever going to invade Soviet or the US, we need anti-tank guns.
Always thinking
ahead.
Like,
I'm really for anti-tank guns. I love them. Since my builds are usually infantry heavy, anti-tank guns is like a must. You can't say no.
So that's where we differ. I never use anti-tank guns.
I can kill tanks. You can't.
Okay, but those tanks, they can just destroy themselves when they're cut off with my motorized divisions.
So you actually can play the game in many different ways, so...
We're being asked for a body count. How many glorious Nippon men have died in China by now?
Not quite
a lot. A staggering 9,000 of them.
Like, why this is going so incredible well for me? I'm just pushing. They don't have supply. I'm just pushing, surrounding. I'm not losing quite so many men in battles. But if they ever would surround me or anything, and also I checked on China, they have only the worst kind of equipment. And they all were missing like 50% of it. And when we attacked so super early, it wasn't their best position either. Oh, right, I need to pick a new natural focus also. I really want more civilian factories right now.
Especially since they're so expensive to build, so.
Since I'm not actually building anything now.
Yeah, all of our all of our factories are currently on repair duty. That is to say that the factory strength we have is being spent on repairing that infrastructure. Oh, and this is a pain
60%.
We get. If you want to be attacking across rivers, invest in some marines. It is marines that get rivers, right?
Let's actually find it. Oh God, it has no supply, so I can't show off.
We're being asked if there is chance factor in combat like dice in EU4.
I don't think
so, not really dice. The only real chance that's going to come in is weather effects. So other than that, it is down to your meticulous planning and preparation. So you can't exactly say, oh no, I rolled a 0 on the fire phase. Because I guess it's almost all fire phase here.
Yeah.
So no. The random element is sufficiently reduced.
Oh, now we're finally seeing why I didn't want to invade China at this point. It's like, I can't push forward. It's just way too hard.
No, nothing is too hard for the best at Hearts of Iron, right?
No, I will eventually win, but I would have won earlier. Here, no, stop it, you're not going over that river. But now you're retreating, so Let's see if I can do this. Occupy them. You're reaching in 4 days. You're reaching the next province in 3 days. Where is my motorized? Maybe you two can just delay them. I will use strategic redeployment. They will lose all their supply. Except, let's see, 5 organization. But they can maybe hold them off enough or just stay there before they reach the actual province. And just gather up at least 1 tick of supply or organization. So just stand there. Ouch. See? The river can work.
Oh, I want to have a look at this if we can pause just in time. So, broken tactics. What has happened there? Because that is a wonderful victory for your general.
Yes, this is one of my... No, this is one of my garrison divisions, seems like. So, it might have just been the pure luck.
Skype.
Here. Yeah, it must have been just pure luck. But my... No, it was pure luck. But my general actually picked the right tactic to counteract his tactic. So, I picked ambush to his shock. So, yeah, they rushed in. We ambushed them.
Oh, yeah. So I guess that is one bit where your chance does come in. You use tactics from your tactics list, which we could actually open here.
Yes.
Depending on the doctrines that you go through, you can unlock different tactics to choose from, and they give bonuses during the battle. But if your general is superior to theirs, you can completely destroy their tactic and any bonus they get from it by choosing the correct one against it. And this is down to your general, so I guess this is where chance comes into it.
Yes, but you can improve that chance by having recon units. So, yeah.
There we go.
Reconnaissance.
Now we can
awesome.
Hit that unpause.
Yeah, it wasn't me who paused that time.
that was me. Guilty as charged.
So, why I did this was I don't want him to get over the river again. I really want to use it to my advantage this time. And why I really want to keep attacking here, because they tried to fall back and defend this city. Here, I will just continue attacking. Even though I will get the horrible river penalty, I don't want them to be able to reinforce anything.
So you are confident in your troops?
No. They will probably lose that battle. Even though I'm winning it, I'm still going to retreat by losing all the organization. But I really want to just keep them occupied. Oh, God, they got 1 cavalry division, probably from here somewhere.
Cavalry division are not so hot at fighting, but they are they're faster than your average infantry, and they make great military police units.
Why they have so super low stats is just they don't have any weapons.
What are they going to do?
Polish Hussar, you? That unit has probably 43% strength of a very low equipment-based army, so it's not possible. Here we can actually see 11 of their fighters joined, but none of mine. Oof, that's actually quite bad. Let's see, hopefully. Come on, some unit should. Come on. No. But hopefully I can show this off pretty soon. Oh god, why is it calling twice? Sorry.
Let's don't see. Think we had mobile phones back in 1937.
No,
Hirohito.
So, let's see. The war overall is going actually really well. But the supply issues are still just damaging my push immensely.
Okay.
I'm really trying just to build up the infrastructure over here so it can get pushed forward to the front. Since it should support a bit more, at least.
Indeed. We did jump into this war pretty much from the get-go, so there wasn't much time to build up our forces. But still, we can give China a run for their money. Whilst Daniel's playing through that, I want to go through a few of the questions that have been jumping up here. Somebody's asking what civilian factories do. We covered that pretty well in one of the earlier ones. But
they do building everything, repairing everything, and you trade with them.
There we go. They are the currency, basically. There's no money to be passed around in this game. The closest thing really is civilian factories, which are used to build pretty much everything and repairing
just
things.
Just one thing quick. Here is what... super good opportunity why motorized is very awesome. I saw that unit had... Oh, he of course reinforced it right away. Like, there my intel was a bit lacking, so I couldn't see he actually had 1 cavalry division there. But I just saw it. Super low organization, super low strength, and I just can quickly push through and maybe surround this whole part. That would be so huge.
Yeah, these are some beaten and bloody units. If they just suddenly saw a motorized division heading their way, they would run for the hills. People are asking about custom starts. We have two start dates.
Yes.
One is 36, the other is 39. 39 is for if you want to jump right into the thick of it.
Let's see actually if any naval battles have been played out. There will be small icons over here, but it doesn't seem like any convoys or anything. If he's not trying to trade with USA, he can probably trade with Soviet Union since they're bordering by land, and I can't really block it off. But nothing by sea, at least. Otherwise, I get now this resistance to occupation, which is kind of bad.
Question coming in if we'll have mod support. Naturally, yes. There'll be mod support for this, as there is with all of our games. How viable and easy is it to go communist or Axis as a major like the US or a minor like Sweden? You'll have a slightly easier time as a minor, but if you do it as a major, you are guaranteed civil war, which you're going to have to pick your side and then win as. If you want to get experience with civil wars, try playing as Spain in the 36 start date. Then you'll have a bit of fun.
It's actually quite hard, civil war.
Oh, heavens,
yes. Since your armies are really equal. Yeah, you can see they're pushing me back now. They have gathered the troops at the border. They actually have full organization, but still not full strength. If I right-click on them, they have somewhere like only 10, 12 military factories. And People's Republic of China also have 8. I am actually in their country, so I can actually see it quite exactly. Why they only have so few is I've probably taken some very good provinces from them. There are some military factories. Yeah, but none of us, neither me or China was actually prepared for the war. So I guess we're kind of equal.
Is it worth putting in any more naval invasions to try and
capture
areas? Yeah,
I was just figuring this out, or thinking about it. Let's see. I really need to reassign them first. Did I ruin it? Yeah, I ruined it. God damn it. No, I didn't. If you do any order with an army that has the garrison area stationed, it will just, let's say I do a naval invasion, it will remove the garrison area order. So first reassign them, just select any units you might want, right click on one open position, right click if you want to assign it to this theater, which I want, and I will actually do a naval invasion. Since I have total superiority, I don't know. I think I actually lured most of the Chinese troops to the border, so I don't think he will have much defending here.
What does our information tell us on their troop numbers? I don't think our decryption is so good.
Around 70 divisions, I would guess. Yeah, we can actually see it straight here in the war screen. Around 70 divisions for China, and around 15, 12.
Okay, so division-wise, we're kind of one for one, but our troops are superior. Of course they are.
Yeah, like I said, I looked in China, they only start with the bad infantry weapons. Like, they only start with basic equipment. I actually start with both, but most of my good units that is doing the attacking have the weapons one researched.
Somebody is asking, can you produce tanks while producing anti-tanks? Yes, and if you rub the two together, that is how nukes are born.
And you can actually, while doing that, research tanks that are anti-tanks.
Ooh, this is tankception. Oh, actually, we've brought up the tanks here. Some people were fairly curious about it. So you're taking the light tank route. You must have your reason for that.
More mobile, basically. They're more mobile. They're much better than motorized. And I don't want to spread my industry out too much. So, and they're quite cheap.
If we shift-click it compared to the heavy tank version, I know there'll be people that are going to be screenshotting this very moment to compare the two.
Actually, let's screenshot the 36 or 35 tanks against each other.
Yeah. Type tank 94
defense,
compared to 95 heavy.
Breakthrough 19 to 27. Breakthrough how easy it is to break through the opponent's defensive value. Hardness, how hard they are. Like, this is a very tank heavy.
Main stats that I really pick up on here is that it costs so much more materials and production cost to put a heavy tank out there.
Yeah.
But if you do have the industrial capacity to be throwing those out, then, yeah, they are going to punch through enemy lines. Slowly, but surely.
Yeah, so I'm going through with the light tank, then when I can, I will go down to the route to the heavier tanks. But I'm actually going to skip medium tanks, I think. I'm maybe going to pick them. I don't actually know now. We will see later. Yeah, one more research slot. Since I'm focusing a bit more on air, I will actually pick... No! First Navy Doctrine. I want my carriers to be a bit better. More organization, sortie, and naval targeting. Yes. Otherwise than that, let's see. I've pushed down very far now. But still, the supply is horrible. Oh, God.
People are asking how deep the mod support will go. I'm not sure if you or I really have the answer for how deep it goes, but...
We will try to make it as moddable as possible. That's why what I've heard. So don't quote me.
Yeah. We wouldn't know about the technical aspect of that.
I really wish. Like, I'm super excited for what all the mods people are going to do.
Also have a question about... Oh, where was it?
Well, we could almost say that we already have mods in the game.
Oh, we do, of course.
Kind of, like... not really mods, since they're game mechanics now, but they started out as anti-Daniel mods. They tried out to... Let's see if we block this to see how badass I can do stuff. I broke it again, and until they became full-fetched game features. So, yeah, that's how you make game design. Add a QA to the mix, and you will see wonders.
There's a question about an arcade mode for the game. I don't believe we have a specific arcade mode in.
No.
That'd be extremely easy to mod in, though. And somebody is asking, is it possible to conquer the world with a smaller nation? Well, I think between you and me, we have the most world conquests in the building.
Yeah, so right now I actually don't know.
Yeah, that's the thing.
We're changing manpower so much to get a good feeling of it. Like, last session I saw someone comment, why do you have 5 million manpower? Because it was a bug that we had twice the amount of manpower we should have. So you can actually see from the current limited conscription law, 2.5% only.
The game goes through so many iterations throughout development that I can't really say, of course you can conquer the world because I did it in this build at this time when there were these quirks and these number tweaks in the game. So it's hard to say. But where there's a will, there's a way. And I have my Albanian will.
Or, like we said, where there's a whip, there's a
whip. Where there's a whip. It's a song favorite in the office.
Especially done during hard times of work.
We're being asked, what does hardness do for tanks? I thought we have hard attack, soft attack, and defensive.
Hardness is basically how much of each soft attack contra to hard attack that division will actually take. Like, all these soft divisions will take 100% of all the soft attacks. If I had some tanks in, it would probably take 80% of all the soft attack and 20% of the hard attack. So, you can almost say that's some kind of combat.
Well, it's not really down to chance, though, that.
What? Oh, of course there's a chance that they will miss the attack and actually defend against the attack, but that's basically how much of each kind of attack they will take. If that is understandable.
We're being asked, what are the really enjoyable nations in multiplayer? I think you've played quite a bit more than I have in multiplayer. What's been the most enjoyable for you?
I just think back at certain moments. It's when I played Germany, all the devs teamed up against me and crushed me. Since, yeah, even I can't beat up to all nations. Like, I basically mean all nations beat up against me. But it was a super fun session. Enjoyable nations. It's actually fun to see a Japanese-Chinese alliance. They just take over the whole of Asia and then challenge the Soviet Union. Finland gathering up with these four nations. Like, it's the nations that usually get annexed or attacked, gather up and fight back.
The Miners' Alliance.
Yeah, that would actually be interesting if they just gather up all Poland, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, Finland, Sweden, Norway, Denmark, and Ireland. Because they also want to join it.
Okay, not to put any pressure, but we made certain promises about China here, so step up your game.
No, I actually didn't say any promise. I said just I would have it unpaused.
Okay.
I never said that I would annex them. I hope.
And anything that wasn't said on stream is not kosher, right?
Oh god, no, I'm really messed up now. Oh god.
Did you just retreat into the enemy?
Yeah, oh! Yep. One whole division, completely wiped.
So how does the overrun mechanic work then, now that you've given us a perfect demonstration of it?
If you try to retreat to a province that you don't own, if your the province they were in were overrun by a unit, they get wiped. Yeah. There are no rooms to retreat.
You've officially gone missing in action.
Ah, oh god. Now, the reason why I really didn't want to invade them now, I'm just stretched out way too far. Let's try to surround them. Actually, I need to go a bit.
I'm particularly happy about this because Daniel plays his best when his back is against the ropes here.
Since I still don't have enough supply. Like, I really need to make people to Republic of China to just surrender, since their lands will be occupied. This is like... Oh, yes, I got them there. Since if I can finally just surround them, I can kill them more easily, since they're completely wiped out from supply, and we have talking a lot about what supply is bad for, or good for. One more interesting thing to see is all my troops. These are seasoned troops. 25% bonus now, finally. And most of the other troops are regulars.
So they're not going to be taking any penalties. Yeah. Now, fresh-faced greenhorns, they are minus 50% to all their combat.
No, you're not doing that, China. No.
You can train them up to trained, which is minus 25% to combat. And then from there, you can even train them up further to regulars. But after that, they're going to need some actual combat experience to get bonuses when it comes to fighting.
Yes. People are asking... Good tool. Doing all this kind of micro is, I can see I have two divisions here and I want one. Just S, select half of them. Like, I've been using S so much.
We actually don't have, we are not on our headsets hearing the game audio. It is going through to you, but not to us.
Yeah.
So people are asking what is the sound, and I am guessing that's because we've got some naval unit that we're selecting.
Oh.
The foghorn will be crying out whenever we select it. I think when you were selecting units earlier, it included a carrier? Or am I imagining things?
I think you're imagining things. Oh, the naval unit?
Okay. I don't know, maybe we're selecting them from time to time. That's the thing, we don't have audio on our end, so we don't know.
So, here's one really interesting focus. Fortress Japan. Super good. I just read the chat. Sorry.
I think for next time we'll get audio through ours so that we'll be able to hear the game audio as well.
Fortress Japan, just putting a bunch of forts in all important places in Japan and some islands everywhere. But I want to take synthetic oil.
Does that give us two synthetic oil bonuses?
Yeah, by research bonuses by 50%. So what is this doing? The first tech is enabling that you can build them. And each synthetic oil factory now provides 5 oil and 2 rubber. We increased it since it was way too little to be able to.
That's
be
pretty
viable.
Incredible. I was already building them, so that's nice.
So, but as you can see, this cost is still 8,750, and I have no factories to spare on anything except repair it.
Yeah, repair that infrastructure. Try to get supply up.
Let's see actually how my supply is currently. 16. So that's why I could finally surround them. And I also took the last state here completely. So I'm getting the supply from here. Oh, God.
You yourself are getting cut off here.
Since I didn't... This is the bad thing about playing high speed. Stuff happens. You don't notice it. Let's clean up some advancement orders. I need one larger one. I've actually lost a couple of divisions. I'm just going to push this up when I finally cleaned up the divisions over here, since they're pretty much meat for the blender. They can't defend this. And I'm going to trap quite a lot of units, but my losses have increased to 26k.
So there we go, the people that were thinking that we were doing too good. There we are, we are only human. And that's 26,000
down the
drain.
I don't have enough units. Like, you could almost say that these units are too expensive for me to produce. I should probably...
It's a lack of equipment that's holding you back, right?
Let's remove 3 of those. That will decrease the need for this division by 300. And I can produce more. Yes. You can actually see. Oh, I didn't know this. Look at this awesome tooltip. I will not save. Oh, this template will be tempting experience less. I will change 17 divisions, 51,000 less manpower, and 5,100 less infantry equipment. So, yes, I will actually do it.
That has cost us 15 of our ample army experience, and it's going to free us up. We can now produce quite a bit more units.
No.
Or hopefully.
We're still missing quite a lot.
Yeah, we're missing some, but it's
but
not going to be such a drain.
I can at least deploy 3 more divisions, and I will just as quickly... Oh, transport.
The legendary Love Muffin, and what a name that is, is asking where can
on,
we ask questions
supply.
That are not covered in the stream. Go over to the Hearts of Iron 4 page on the Paradox Plaza forums. We have a thread up. It's called WWW Tomorrow. It's a thread that was posted by Daniel himself. Throw questions in there, and we'll do our best to answer them. If not in a future stream, then we might just pop in and answer them in the thread itself.
I will also most, if we continue this next week, depending on what you want, I will do one more of that, what you want to see next time.
People are wanting to see how that second naval invasion of yours did.
Oh, right.
Those poor forgotten souls in the south. Well, what is quite fortunate is that the Chinese themselves have forgotten about you.
No, more like they're occupied with all the... Oh, God, no.
They're occupied with defeating you.
No. that could have been really bad. But it's because all of these divisions are now just busy on surrounding and destroying the units. As you can see, they only have one unit left here, actually being capable of defending anything. So when I wiped it out, we will see some nice losses. 402,000 will be increased to...
We're being told more or minus 10,000 stability.
Oh, and 135k.
Fortunately, there is no stability in this game, so we can take all the stab hits we want.
And yeah, look at this supply.
It's looking nice and green.
Let's actually see. I took that naval base now.
Now, this man is living on a wing and a prayer here, because if he gets caught by the Chinese...
Sending some more troops.
There we go.
I have complete naval superiority, so I can just do it. They can't argue with me, basically. I don't like this. Oh, it's scary, actually. I really want to just continue. Oh, wait. I've cleaned it up completely now. Yes. All units are assigned to that order. Start getting their planning bonus, since planning bonus is, great. Extra 80% attack. So, my tanks are finally finished. And execute.
But even though you have those tank designs essentially finished off, you can't actually simply click your fingers and deploy them, can you? You're going to have to build them.
Yes. I'm going to show it very quickly, but now they actually added some troops there. And let's assign you actually to this order instead. And let's do a small expansion. Like you see, when they draw it, they can handle this long offensive line. They kind of can handle this, and they can't handle it. It will take way too much time, but I will actually try it anyway, and hopefully reassign some troops.
You're going to tell four divisions
right
to do
away.
The work of 20. I'm sure they'll be fine.
I know, actually. But I can actually just send more troops. I'm just instantly deploying them now, since I need more men. I have 5 additional divisions. I can just actually click to assign to that front line, and they will just, so I should use the boat all the way and go to that defensive line. Otherwise, it's going quite well now, since I cleaned up, I got the supply needed, and I'm pushing on several fronts. This new research should go to tactical bombers. So
we've already destroyed a fair chunk of the infrastructure there, but why do you want more bombers?
Close air support to help my troops continue. God damn it, I didn't get any battle where my actual planes were active. Since they're not in the active zone anymore, I need to move them up. Sorry, I'm going to pause here. Since I really need good
control. Could
have
at least paused on the Hindenburg disaster.
Oh, right.
What a disaster.
So I'm just moving up all my airplanes and assigning them to Eastern Zone. as soon as they arrived. So, and I'm gonna actually, let's take half of these there and just assign this area.
Glenn Mordor is asking more about the mass assault and superior firepower doctrines, but I think we'll cover those at another time when we are not knee-deep in Asian warfare.
Let's continue. And oh, finally, now I actually forgot about it. Not like last time. I'm gonna pick him, which will increase my infantry attack and defense, and that's it.
And this is what you can spend your political power on, or at least one of the things you can spend them on. It's not just used for new laws. You can also get the backing of certain factories and companies and some advisors or military experts.
Oh, good. Now finally this arrived. I'm quite actually not sure why this in China, why I can't manage the occupation law. Maybe I need a certain amount. It, like we say, the bill is brand new, and so I might actually not know all the requirements needed. But as you can see, we now start on gentle. You're not...
Are you a gentle guy?
No. But we actually increased, for every state, it's going to cost some political power to handle it, since you're going to need more better office or better governors.
I think administration is probably the word.
Exactly. So if you want harshest, like if I did it last time with World of Wednesday, when I occupied, not when I had control over it, when I occupied half Soviet Union, it would cost me probably like 2 political power.
And given your base income of political power is 2 per day, it's going to cost quite a bit to keep that going.
More as you start actually with more with Germany.
You do?
But they have the national focus, Adolf Hitler.
The ultimate national focus.
Or, yes, dictator. Yeah.
Political power game plus 50. Good job. Somebody's asking how easy it would be to mod your national focuses. If you're good with Notepad, you'll be fine.
Oof, very interesting. No, it's time for Warrior Traditions. Base National Unity plus 5%. Very good. Get National Spirit, Warrior Traditions, National Unity 15%, and Division Recovery by 10.
So what is Division Recovery in that sense?
How quickly they can regain their morale.
Okay. So the organization will come back faster after you...
Yes.
Well, let's say you want to strategically redeploy them back a bit. They'll be ready to fight on the front lines faster.
Yes. Let's see. What should I pick? I'm going to take the logistics company. Like we say all the time with supply. This will help you. Oh, cut them off.
That is the ultimate way to win.
We're still all the values, how the game works, everything can be changed.
Yeah. That's also part of why going through all the doctrines and what each of them do is almost a moot point, since the values are still very much open to tweaking. D-Day is a while away. And in case you were living under a rock, we are releasing Hearts of Iron 4 on D-Day. So,
finally,
take part in that great operation.
I'm so... Oh! Oh, we just heard 5 minutes left.
Oh, man. I think I can almost agree with the chat this time.
So here,
10%
more attack. Or attack and defense. They will defend against 10% more attacks. And 10 more organization.
Yes.
That's a flat 10. That's, and you can also show what it affects when you hover over the all infantry part.
All infantry.
Haha.
Nice
so
one.
Even I know some things you don't.
Or more like, I just know it, so I don't really check it anymore.
I could never compare to the best at Hearts of Iron, right?
We're not even talking about the game.
They just want one more hour. One more day.
Oh, right. This is one pretty good thing to show off, actually.
Why Studios 10 says they have an exam on D-Day. So, well, just write Hearts of Iron and then go and play the game.
Some people asked about the toasters. It's actually the natural spirit I got from doing this focus. It's gains natural spirit, imperial austerity.
Yeah. Austerity.
Austerity?
Yeah,
my English, great, we learn. Which grants consumer goods factories minus 5%. So the factories, 20% that are being restricted, will get reduced. Just plain by additional or reduction.
Yeah, so depending on your rules, a certain percentage of the factories you have, you won't be able to use for building, trading, etc.
Here. Like, it counts both civilian and military factories, 60 in total, minus 20% only from civilian goods, and then additional minus just 5% of those. So required civilian factories, 9. Just think of them producing food, clothes.
We're being asked if Stalin has a trait like Hitler does.
I'm pretty sure he does not.
No? What maybe about under details? Is there a special thing for the Soviets?
Maybe something that hasn't been implemented.
Possibly.
Right, so, new fighters. And I actually need to implement the new tanks. Let's see, I have a good amount of support equipment, but I'm not gaining so much every day because I'm actually losing from all the battles. Motorized, I'm actually gaining a bit, so I'm going to remove 2 factories from motorized. I'm going to remove 1 from artillery. I'm going to remove 1 from infantry. Increase this by 2.
Will we just have them as is?
And there. No, that's actually a very good point. I should, since they're actually restarting from 0.
Yeah, we have enough time here.
Then I will actually add some.
Now, during Daniel's clash against Johann, lots of people asked why they weren't using the stars at the top, which were capped out at 500. And this is really what you will want to use them for. So we have this new Fighter 1, but straight away we have enough experience to create a variant of it. And although it's being called the KI-27 Mark 1, we can call it whatever we want. And I believe you had someone in mind.
I did, though.
He's good at navies, but I'm pretty sure that skill can just be applied in the air as well, right?
Pretty good navies. No, I'm actually just keep it as, let's name it the XP4 Twitch. EXP Twitch. No, that's a bad name. Just let's call it EXP. He's the one you finally made. The EXP one.
The XP.
Be happy. But actually, that reminded me of the other thing. I'm actually going to steal... Oh, God! I never assigned a commander to this one.
Actually, chat did point that out earlier, but I didn't want to question your methods. I'm sure you had a plan here. Great name, 10.
I'm actually going to name this by a really cool dude from Korea that I actually learned from. Admiral G, the most badass commander ever. I was just mind blown by him. So we're actually going to name the whole... Like, let's say we took his lessons and implemented for our navy.
I like to think we time-traveled, captured him, and said, you're in charge of our navy now. And for some reason, he agreed.
Concentrated industry. Yes, quickly. The best thing ever. Like, I love this.
Well, that said, dispersed industry got a nice buff of its own, actually, with the... Where did it even go? Production efficiency loss. I quite like that.
Yeah, it's this everyone pick concentrated every time. So we actually now it's a quite hard choice actually.
Yeah, because we eat what we make around here.
Yes, so he was Korean.
Yeah.
Didn't I say it?
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, he actually helps the Japanese now.
We're actually pretty much out of time. If you have any final questions, throw them in right now.
Because I don't want to.
I don't want to either. Actually, I don't think we're going to have any. Okay. Does Daniel know that Yi was Chinese? Was he Chinese?
Was he Chinese?
Okay.
Okay.
If you say so.
You're probably better in history than me. Oh, God. You can actually see.
The last question we're going to take before we wrap this up. Can censored Hitler marry uncensored Stalin?
No.
I'm not gonna say he can't.
Mods.
Mods. There Mods. We go. Mods are the answer.
Do it.
But that's
fan
all
art,
from us.
Fan art.
Fan art. Oh, I want the best fan art. Fan of art. Censored Hitler and uncensored Stalin. Okay. Yes. But yeah, we're out of time. But that's it from us for this World War Wednesday. If you want to see more, get it there on the forums. And
write in the comments. We might just have lots of comments like more Hearts of Iron single player. And don't comment about my hair. It's like the top rated comment was my hair.
As it should
write
be.
Write more Hearts of Iron.
More Hearts of Iron.
Do it.
Because yeah, we want to be here as well. Yeah. We enjoy doing this. And we hope you do too. But from us, for now, that's it. There's not going to be Worst Wedding Wednesday next. There is going to be Worst Worktoria 2. I don't even know how to Worktoria. Spin that. I don't know. Factories Forever. Something like that. Bjorn is actually on VAB at the moment, so we'll be having Stephen come in for that. But from us, that is all. We got to get back to work, unfortunately. Yeah. But yeah, cheers, guys. See you later.